My name is Nick Mead, and I upload video game commentaries, live commentaries, and machinimas on YouTube.
All right, and what was your initial inspiration to start a YouTube channel, and what were your first thoughts about it?
Well, I was almost done with my film school. I went to a 16-month program, and I wanted something that was kind of like a regular release of creative juices, you know, because making, making like short films and stuff takes a while. Like if you want them to be good, yeah, it takes a long time. So my desktop PC was like in the shop for a while. And so I had this little rinky-dink netbook I was using to like write scripts on and stuff. And I could, I could watch videos on YouTube on it and stuff. So I'd watch, actually C-Manner's videos. I watched a lot of his videos and Hutch's videos. And I was like, oh, like back then I was like really big into Call of Duty. Like that was almost all I played. I lived with my two friends, and we all had Xboxes in our room, and we just played Call of Duty every night when they were both back, when I got back from school and they got back from work. We would just hop on and play Call of Duty all night. So I was like, well, you know, like I could potentially afford a capture device of some sort, and I've got some ideas running through my head of different types of commentary I could do. So I got an easy cap. I think I made like two videos with that until I upgraded to the Dazzle, and shortly after that I moved on to the HD, the Hophog HD PVR. So that was like how I started doing, like what inspired me. It was just kind of like, oh, like I like all this gaming stuff, and I think I have a unique take on how to do commentaries and stuff like that. So I'll just figure it out as I go along.
In the beginning, when you first, I guess, got your easy cap and your Dazzle, what do you think the biggest mistake was? Like when you started
getting an easy cap and a Dazzle.
For those that haven't been around, would you explain what those are? I mean, some people are pretty new to YouTube, but I mean, if you've been doing it for a while, you know what the Easy Cap and Dazzle are.
Yeah, basically, the Easy Cap and the Dazzle is the equivalent to like recording live video game like footage is the equivalent of like having two VCRs or three. What is it? Three VCRs and a video and like a video monitor, and you're trying to edit a movie by starting and stopping and recording on and dubbing over like stuff on one tape with another tape. Like it's the same process. It's just like, it's just so shitty, and it's cheap. The Easy Cap I got was like $8 and it recorded exactly like it was $8.
How did you find the time to do that stuff? I mean, did you have a job at the time, or were you just dedicating most of your time to like, you know, putting out this kind of content and trying to get your name out there on YouTube?
Since I started YouTube, this was the first job I've had since starting YouTube. I've had like gigs come up from knowing from like my contacts in the film business industry around here in Northern California. So mostly my parents were you know, they're supporting me, but every so often I get some sort of PA gig or some sort of, you know, like editing gig or something like that that would help me out a little bit. But it wasn't until like a year and a half, 2 years later that I started to really like see the financial gain. Like I was getting to the point where I was like, I can pay rent, I can pay my bills on my own, you know, like all this is making a little more sense.
So what was the biggest issue, do you think, during the lifespan right now of your YouTube, from past to present, that you faced on like to grow your YouTube channel, not just in general about editing and software and hardware, but like as a whole, what was the most difficult thing you found?
It's hard to say. I mean, for the first year, I was working off of a laptop. So I couldn't render more than one video like a day I could have, but it was just like I didn't want to do that because my computer was so shitty. I didn't want to like fry it by doing a batch render or something. So for a while there, it was just like one video every couple of days, and I was fine with that. But I guess like the biggest thing that's still an issue and always was an issue, especially in gaming, is that it's just so oversaturated. Like completely oversaturated with people wanting to do this.
If you could suggest one thing to aspiring YouTubers now, which obviously has changed a lot since you started, you know, you had all this technological issue. Now it's kind of like there's almost a default. All right, use Sony Vegas, use the Elgato, or use one of the new capture cards that's easy HDMI in, HDMI out. What would you suggest to them if they wanted to make it a full-time job someday?
I've thought about that a lot, and I honestly don't even know. Like, I try to look back on, like, how I started, and, like, I mean, everyone says this. No one, like, they always say that they didn't start YouTube as, like, they wanted it to be a career, and I didn't, mostly because I didn't know it could be for the first, like, 6 months or so. And then after that, I think I got my, I was like 6,000 subscribers is when I got my partnership. And even then, I was still kind of like, oh, cool, a little bit, little tiny bit of money is coming in. That's fine. That's all good. But like starting a channel now, like I started a second channel a while back, and it's still like hovering underneath 30,000 subscribers, you know, like even with my larger channel there, like piggybacking, like holding it up, it's still not a lot of traction there. So I honestly wouldn't even know what to tell someone aside from, like, if you want to, like, make videos and like have fun making videos, like go for it. I'm not gonna tell you not to do that. That's bullshit. But, like, you know, don't expect to get a whole lot out of it, because I see a lot of, I'm on forums and stuff, and I see a lot of bright eyed like little YouTubers out there just like trying to get their name out there, and they're just going about it the completely wrong way, sub for sub, you know, like I'll pay money to be in someone's sub box. Like that stuff still happens, and it's kind of depressing when you think about it. I guess, yeah, the biggest thing is just don't really go into it with that idea that you're going to make it a job or a career, because that very well probably won't happen. You know, mm-hmm. Like focusing all your energy on that is just really unwise, really unwise. If you're just starting from scratch.
All right. Well, last question here is, now that you have quite a bit of experience with YouTube, what do you see as the largest challenge in front of you currently?
Taxes.
What are you talking about? The government shut down. You don't have to worry about taxes.
Oh yeah. Let's hope that goes through April. For me personally, I have like really bad ADHD, actually clinically diagnosed. I'm not just saying that because it's a fucking thing people say sometimes when they can't focus. So like juggling all these things, like I've got, like it's gotten to the point where I get all these offers from different companies and stuff, and it's like, it's really difficult for me to like kind of hone in and focus on which ones are like the ones that are legitimate, which ones are worth my time, you know, like what kind of projects I really want to be invested in. It's a fun job, but it also is a job. So you have to like kind of go at it that way, with the attitude of someone who has like an actual schedule of things to do. So for me, that's always been kind of a challenge, just because I can only focus on so many things at once.
Well, that's good, man. I appreciate it. That's
no problem.